Obviously, you are not a World War II veteran.
No, I'm not.
Talk about World War II, though. You have something that became of interest to you that you've been studying and you've been looking into.
Yeah. A couple of years ago, I and some other folks founded a group called Democracy Rising PA, and the whole notion of this is to try to improve integrity in public service in Pennsylvania. And as I've done this, of course, it's very patriotic work. And I would tell my mom, who is now approaching 94, tell her what I was up to. And about 2 years ago, she opened a box that I didn't even know that she had. And she pulled from that box this ring that belonged to my uncle. It is a pilot officer ring from the United States Army Air Force. My uncle was in World War II. He was killed in action as a pilot in the South Pacific. And it was about 5 years before I was born that he died. And she kept this ring in that box with his flight log and his Bible and his Purple Heart and a couple of other effects. And then about 2 years ago, she gave it to me and she said, "Wear this ring because you're living for what he died for." Which was pretty powerful stuff, you know? I mean, really. And as I've thought about it a great deal over the years, these past 2 years. And one of the things that occurs to me is that he had no idea when he died whether democracy and freedom were going to survive in the world. He had no idea. And we all do things as a matter of faith, but that is an exceptional degree of faith, to put your life on the line for these things that are terribly abstract in one respect, but terribly real in another respect. And so I wear the ring all the time, and I talk about it when I do public speaking, just to remind people that ordinary people do extraordinary things, and we all have something to contribute if we pay attention to things that are bigger than ourselves.
Nowadays, often, people in the military, people serving in Iraq and Afghanistan are called heroes. Mm-hmm. Most often, the veterans of World War II are described as heroes. When you describe your uncle's service and what it stood for and what it means some 60 years later, he was a hero.
Yeah, he certainly was. You know, an ordinary guy from the middle of Kentucky who stepped up to the plate in a time of need. And the other thing I've thought about, particularly living in Carlisle with the Army War College. My wife and I have gotten to know a number of people who work at the War College, who have come in and out from the War College. And the fact of the matter is that there is evil in the world. And every one of us has to confront it, or it won't go away. It probably won't go away, even if we do confront it, but at least we can keep it at bay. You know. And my generation that opposed the war in Vietnam missed that. It was pretty clear in World War II who the bad guys were. You know, it was pretty clear that evil was going to prevail unless we all had a hand in stopping it. It's something that my generation, I think, doesn't really appreciate as much as it should. These kinds of stories in other people's heads.
Now, 2 years later, during the ensuing 2 years, you mentioned that you wear your uncle's ring. What do you know more about him? What have you learned about him in those 2 years?
Oh, not a whole lot. I mean, my mom and I have talked about him a bit. She talks mostly about the kind of person that he was. She says that I favor him in some respects. You know, he was a very idealistic person, and people have called me very idealistic because of what I do. He was a terrific athlete, but I don't know much about his military service, so I've started digging into that at the Army War College, the Military History Institute, to see what more I can find out about his service.
What do you want to know? What do you want to know about him?
I want to know where he served. I want to know the circumstances where he died, what it was like, if it was, what happened in the battle. Was it a random act of, just somebody who happened to be in the wrong place at the wrong time for no particular reason, like the IEDs that happened in Iraq? Or was it part of a grand campaign and he was, fulfilling his role as part of that mission? I just don't know.
Now, you mentioned that today's generation and probably the generation before lost a lot of what the men and women who served in World War II fought and served for.
Yes.
What would you like, what message would you like to leave with people today seeing this?
Nobody, and I don't care whether it's someone who's alive today or someone who has preceded us or someone who comes after us, no one wants to think that they've lived their lives in vain. And for people to fight evil, and for us not to respect that, and us not to pay attention and do the most ordinary things that we're allowed to do and other people are not allowed to do, like voting, like paying attention to what's happening in public affairs, like insisting on integrity in government. If we can't do those things, then we really have decided that those people gave up their lives for nothing. And I just don't want to be part of that. And it's something that I have worn ever since, and I will not give it up, because it's such a powerful symbol to me of what I'm working for and what he died for. The ring symbolizes to me a connection with my mom, of course, but also with the uncle that I did not know. And it symbolizes that if somebody can die for democracy, then certainly I can live for democracy.